Hello students, and welcome to the final video of this lesson. In this video, we're going to be using some of our Riemann sums, whether that's left, right, mid, or trapezoid, and we're going to be using those from table values. So let's get started. So in our first problem, it's asking us to approximate 0 to 25 f of x dx, or the integral from 0 to 25 of f of x dx, using a midpoint sum and three sub-intervals. So I'm looking from 0 to 25, and really I just need to cut this into three sections. So I could have one section here, one section here, and then our final section here. Yes, they're overlapping, and that's exactly what midpoint sums were doing. They were kind of sharing the edge of that rectangle. So that's how you want to look at it. So I want to see, okay, what is the midpoint of each of these intervals? So I have a midpoint here at 4, I have a midpoint at 12, and I have a midpoint at 20. Remember, we're going to find the base and the height for all of these. So we're going from 0 to 25 of f of x dx. And that's gonna be approximately, so the base of my first one, because it's baseline type for all of these rectangles, you wanna view them all as rectangles. So the base of my first one is 7, because it's going from 0 to 7, times the height. The height is gonna be at the midpoint, which is f of 4, which is 6, plus what is the base of our next rectangle? Well, that's gonna go from 7 to 15, so that is a base length of 8. And what is the height of the midpoint? Well, that is going to be negative 10. Plus our final section, which is the length between 15 and 25, which is 10, times the height of the midpoint, which is f of 20 equal to 8. So we're going to calculate these values. So that comes out to be 42 minus 80 plus 80, which comes out to be 42. So that's how we can use tables now. And what you want to keep in mind is when we're doing our intervals before, when we had a graph and we had a function, we were able to get exact values and have very clean intervals. That's not going to be the case when we're working with tables. So just keep that in mind. Moving on to our second problem, we're going to be using a left-hand sum, and make sure that you do read this properly. This is going from 0 to 15, but I don't care about those. And we're going to be using four sub intervals. So my first interval is going to be 0 to 4, and then I get 4 to 7, and then I get 7 to 12, and then I get 12 to 15. That's the left and the right hand sum. And we're going from 0 to 15. So the integral from 0 to 15 of f of x dx. So what is the base of my first rectangle? Well, from 0 to 4, that is going to be a base of 4. And what is the height? Well, we are using left-hand sum, so I need to grab the left hand of that interval. So that's f of 0, which is going to be 15, plus our next interval, which is going to be a base of 3. And the height, we're going to grab the left one, so that's going to be f of 4, which is 6, plus the base, so from 7 to 12, that's going to be 5, times the height, we're grabbing it from the left hand, so that's going to be f of 7, which is negative 5. And then our last interval from 12 to 15, that's a base of 3. And the height, we're going to grab it from the left part of that interval, that's going to be negative 10. F of 12 is negative 10. We're going to make these calculations. So that's going to be 60 plus 18 minus 25 minus 30, which comes out to be about 23. And again, we're just keeping the approximation signs as we go through this. But you're just cutting off your intervals, and you're being very clear, these left, right, midpoint, trapezoids, and you're using those same calculations that we learned about before. So now I'm gonna let you guys go ahead and take a stab at these last two problems, C and D. All right, and that is going to be our two calculations. So in part C, we have negative 31, and in part D, you have 97. You might be wondering, can we have negative area? And yes, that represents that the area between the x-axis and the curve is going to be below the x-axis. There's a deeper reason why that is happening, but we're going to learn about that in the future when we start to find area between things that have like two curves. Of course, if you need help finding these answers, or if you're not exactly sure how to make which numbers to pick every single time, you want more practice, please reach out to me. I'm Mr. Hernandez, and this was Mr. Hernandez Teaches.